Well, you join me down at my syndicate water. This is Farriers Lake in the Cotswold Water Park. And looking at me, all huddled up in the cold, you wouldn't think that it's nearly May. It's absolutely freezing. But I've come down for probably one of my last sessions that I'm gonna fish on this lake. I'm dropping my ticket this year. So I thought I'd drag the cameras along, see if we can get a fish for the cameras. But yeah, I got down earlier, seen a few fish at this end of the lake. So I got set up and the wind spun, the heavens opened, and I absolutely thumped it down for like 3 hours. So I'm freezing cold. The night's drawing in as well. So I'm gonna cook a bit of tea, see what the night brings. And hopefully, fingers crossed, well, the rods are in the water, so we've got a chance. Well, I just stood there looking for any signs because looking pretty dismal to be fair, and just seen a really nice fish welly out sort of just to my right off of the side of where I'm fishing, and seems I've not baited up there or anything like that. I'm just gonna pop a little zig out there. So I've just tied up a little zig about sort of 14-15 inches below the surface. I'm gonna flick that out to where I saw one show. Yeah, come on. Well, that's that rod, bang on where that fish showed. I've caught a couple on zigs last spring out of here. So that's well worth a shot. You know, and this time of year, with the way the weather is as well, it's absolutely freezing. And yeah, I just think that's definitely worth a shout. Yeah. Fingers crossed. The night's drawing in now, pretty quick. We're going to lose light. I've just freshened the spot up, just with literally three spots. Put the rod nice and fresh on the bottom and a nice fresh pop up. So that rod's sorted. I've got the zig where I've seen a couple of fish show. So hopefully one of those two rods will do me a bite. If not, in the morning, I'll either be looking to move or maybe get two rods on zigs at showing fish. Just have to see how it goes. But I mean, is that my finger's gone numb already? I can't believe we're nearly into May and I've got a numb finger from spotting. Absolutely ridiculous. Talking of ridiculousness, I'm absolutely starving as well, so I'm going to crank the old Cadillac on, get a nice bit of steak and a nice burger on the go. Well, if I don't see you in the night, I'll see you in the morning. Morning. Quiet night for me, nothing to report. I thought maybe I had an outside chance of catching. You know, that's a nice spot that I'm fishing on there, but they're clearly not out in this open water. I heard a fish rattle out up to my right, so I've had a little mooch. This morning I just walked out the bank and I could see a few fizzers, and I actually saw two fish show as well up to my right, and I heard a couple of fish to my left. I'm in a bit of a predicament. It seems like they're in the corners and I don't know, do I go left, do I go right? I don't know. My gut feeling says to go to the right. So I'm going to finish this coffee, I'm going to get my camp packed down, get on the barrow, and then I'm going to make my mind up which corner I'm going to go into. But they're definitely not out in this open water at the moment. They just seem to be tucked out the wind in the corners. This one up to my right's a little bit deeper, and that's where my gut's telling me to go out there. So yeah, let's get packed down. First rod out, not set any kit up or anything, or literally just got that rod, flicked a little zig out into the area where I've seen a couple showing, and where I've seen them fizzing is a bit closer into the bank, so I think whether they're sort of rooting the bottom up here and then drifting out off the bottom and showing, I'm not sure, but I'm just going to put the zig in the open water, and then I'm going to get a bag or some sort of like little wafty hook bait and try and get it around this corner to where they're fizzing in, you know, closer to the bank. Yeah, sounds like a start to a plan. Job's a good end. That's that first rod out, that zig, that's out in the open water. And my second rod, I'm going to get down this margin where they've been fizzing up. It looks like they're fizzing up on the bottom of the marginal shelf. And I think like the perfect presentation for that, not knowing or not plumbing up, is going to be a solid bag. I've got a lot of faith in them, I'm sure, as a lot of people have. And my little bag rig is nice and simple. I just got the long flexi ring swivel bag stem. I've just forever used a 3.5 ounce weight on my bags. It's just a really good. You can chuck them miles, or they're not too heavy to just chuck down the margin. A little 4-inch 20 pound pin down hook length, a size 6 armor up wide gape hook, and then just I've got a few various colors that are in the bag, so I've got some that are pre-tied already in the bucket, which is, you know, that's the sort of good thing about the bags then, really. You can just loop to loop them and flick them down when you're fishing straight away. You've not got to mess around. But yeah, let's get this bag out, get down that edge. Burned most of the day out sort of sitting behind these rods, that bag down the edge and the zig in open water, and yeah, nothing's happened, nothing looks like it's going to happen, and I don't really want to go into tonight with sort of a negative approach. You know, I've always fished quite positive, so what I'm going to do is, just so I can go to sleep with peace of mind, I'm going to get 4 spods of hemp, some 8mm bug, and a few grains of corn, not too much corn, I don't want to attract too much bird life. But I'm going to put 4 spots on one spot with a rod over the top, and then I'm going to get a rod. A few fish have showed out in open water now, so I know that there's a little area out there, so I'm probably going to set up pretty much the same. I might put just a few more spots out there, maybe 6 or 8, and then one rod on that. Just, yeah, there's not a lot more I can do. Proving quite a tricky session, to be fair. Let's get on with it.
So when I'm fishing, I've done it ever since I used to fish horseshoe, really. But I've always used microelastic. Every time I go fishing, I see people just wrapping up, they're winding, wrap their rods back up around their stick, chuck back out, catch a fish, wrap it back up. If you just put a piece of elastic marker at your tip, either when you go to wind in, you can just hold the elastic marker at the tip, clip it up and wind it in and rechuck it. Or even, you know, if you get a take, 9 times out of 10, it'll take line. You can just clip it up on the way back in. Just saves you hours. I've done it ever, like, all my life. A lot of people I know do it, but I still see so many people not doing it. And trust me, it's an absolute game changer. Yeah, so I'm gonna tie elastic marker on the spot that I've just prepared for tonight. I'm just preparing my fishing rod to chuck out over the top. And I'm gonna put my elastic marker on, and then that means that I do not have to wrap up another rod for that spot for the remainder of the session. I know exactly where it is. So yeah, show you how to tie it. Yep. First of all, if you just strip off about 4 or 5 inches of your Avid Carp marker elastic, and then once you've got your 5-inch section, if you lie it parallel to your main line, and then you're basically gonna create a loop, and then you just pass the tag end around the main line and the elastic through the loop 4 times. And then all you need to do is just lubricate the knot a little bit with a bit of spit or water, pull down tight and trim your tag ends off about 5 mil. A thing that I've always done is use 2 marker elastics next to each other, about 1.5 to 2 inches apart. This way, you can always tell if one of them's ever slipped. It's not in the net yet by any means, but seen him. He's a nice mirror. There's, I'm sure some of you probably know that there's an awful lot of commons in this lake. They are massive. So yeah. But I am not complaining. Whew. Well, that's a relief, I'm not gonna lie. Chuffed to have caught this one. Yeah, nice fish. Certainly a good 20 pounder. Made up. Absolutely made up. I mean, yeah. Smidgen under 30 pound, lovely Farriers mirror carp. One that I didn't see I'd be having a cuddle with, to be honest. But we've rung the changes and got the bite. You're only ever that one bite away from getting success fishing. You know, you just got to keep the faith. You're always, I always say it to loads of people, you're just one bite away. It's a massive, you know, sometimes you feel so far away. And then 10 minutes later, you think, oh, yeah, made up, mission accomplished. Oh, yeah, lovely mirror. Behaving nicely as well. Gonna get a few stills of this one. Might get a few water shots actually. There's a nice margin up there. Yeah. Thank you very much. Very welcome indeed. Lovely, thank you very much, buddy. A lovely fish, made very welcome. See you later. Go on, mate. There's my little zig. It's been a while since I had that fish, and I'm just tying up a couple of fresh ones. And the zig is by no means anything revolutionary. It has been around for donkeys of years, and the reason for that is because time after time, it is still catching loads and loads of carp. I've got ultimate faith in them. I absolutely love zigs, especially in the spring. You know, when those hatches are coming off, or the sun's out and the fish are up, getting a bit of sunlight, they're absolutely awesome. You can catch as many fish on these as what you would on the bottom, without a shadow of a doubt, if not probably more on these. And I simply start off by taking the length that I need of the outline zig and floater line. I tie a small figure of eight loop, which will be my little hair stop loop. I then thread on a very small piece of hook silicone tubing. I then take a size 6 Armorock wide gape hook, and I simply take the point end of the hook, pass it through the silicone tubing. It's worth noting that I actually have the hook point. You need to face it down towards the loop. So when you slide it round the hook, the loop, your hair loop, is obviously coming off the bottom of the shank of the hook. I then take the other end of the zig line and I pass it through the back of the eye. Then I pull it all through and set the length of the hair that I want to match the piece of foam that I'm going to use as a hook bait. I then go around the shank of the hook 7 or 8 times, and then pass the line back through the back of the eye so it exits out the front. I then pull the line through, and this will make you a lovely knotless knot. So then all I'm left to do is to choose my hook bait. And generally, in clear water, like where I'm fishing now, I use a black hook bait. And instead of using a boilie stop, I use a very small piece of either yellow or red foam as a hair stop. This just adds a little fleck of colour. I think it just puts a nice little twist on it. So there you have it. Very simple and easy to tie. A really effective method at this time of year. And just a few little tips, if you're looking at using them for the first time, is be confident. Stick them on all your rods if you're going to have a go on them. And a starting point for your depth is probably 18 inches to 2 foot below the surface. Make sure that you use good bite indication. So either use a nice heavy bobbin or a slightly tight line. And don't be afraid, if you see a carp show, get a rod, cast straight into to where the fish has jumped, because 9 times out of 10 they'll be loitering around. And having one of these just in the area, they can often go for it pretty quickly. After a quiet night last night, I've decided to wind the rods in off the bottom and get back on the zigs for today. I've seen a couple of fish show, so I've just plopped 2 zigs in the area where I've seen 2 fish show. But I just thought I'd, obviously because I took this rig off of the rig that I've wound in, just thought I'd show you what I chucked out on the bottom last night. Now, when the spots are all really nice and polished and like an old snooker table, then it's fine having a really short little boom section that can be like a bit stiffer. However, at the minute, being this time of year and the fish aren't really sort of cleaning the spots off as much as I'd like them to, I've just opted for a slightly longer outline fluoro boom, and that's just in the 15 pound. This is a lot more supple, so if the leg clip goes down and lands, if there's any sort of debris or anything, you've got the flexibility in the hook link to just move around it and still sit down, whereas if you had a rigid hook length, it could potentially stick up or poke out at a funny angle if there's any debris on the spot. So it's just something worth taking into consideration when you're actually putting your rigs out over the top of your spot. Although it's, you know, you might know that it's a gravel spot or that there's gravel there, but it might just be a little bit covered over or have a little bit of leaf matter on it from the winter. Then it's worth just taking into consideration maybe just a slightly longer boom section and being a little bit more supple. The actual hook arrangement is a nice, good old trusty size 6 Armorock curve. I absolutely adore this, especially in the barbless pattern that I'm using here on this lake. I've hardly lost a fish on this over the years. It's absolutely perfect. And I've just got that on a nice little Ronnie swivel where I've actually nipped off the bigger ring. That just gives me a little bit more balance, like critically balanced with the 12 mil pop up rather than using a bigger hook bait. That's absolutely perfect. But I've got an hour or so left of my session. I'm really hoping that, you know, something snaps one of these zigs up, because they are out there. I've seen the odd fish and they're out there cruising around, so anything could happen. But yeah, like I say, not long left now before I head off. Fingers crossed for a last minute bite. That's a wrap for me this trip. I managed that lovely fish just under 30 pounds, which is, you know, that's a big fish. Although there's a lot bigger fish in this lake, they've been a bit tricky to catch this trip. Can't have it good always. It is, you know, it is just fishing. I'd like it to be fishing a little bit better than what it is, but I don't think the weather's done us any favors. It's been a cold old trip, this one, considering the time of year that it is. But yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed this video. You've liked what you watched. If you have, make sure you like and subscribe to the YouTube channel so you can watch future videos. And maybe if you think I should have done something a little bit different on this trip, maybe drop your thoughts in the comments below. So I'll be sure maybe next time it'll be in the back of my mind and I'll give it a go. Might even help me catch a fish or two.